Nicotine is the main psychoactive component of tobacco. It is primarily consumed by inhaling the smoke of tobacco cigarettes. Within around 10 seconds of taking a puff, nicotine reaches the brain. In the brain, nicotine triggers the release of dopamine, also called the happy hormone, and other neurotransmitters. Dopamine stimulates the reward system in the brain that induces pleasurable feelings. This is what makes smoking very addictive. Chronic smoking results in repeated dopamine surges in the brain. Over time, the reward system gets desensitized and becomes less responsive to other factors that trigger dopamine release. With continued nicotine intake, the body gets used to high dopamine levels and will need higher amounts of nicotine to create pleasurable effects. This is what is described as nicotine dependence. Nicotine dependence has been tied to an increased risk of various health conditions. Tobacco smoking, to date, remains the most established contributor to lung cancer. It also increases the risk of many other types of cancers. In fact, smoking contributes to 30% of all deaths due to cancer. Nicotine and other chemicals from the cigarette cause constriction of blood vessels, restricting blood flow. This also results in the thickening of blood vessels, which traps more platelets, increasing the risk for blood clots. All these effects on the blood vessels increase the risk for heart attacks and stroke. Smoking during pregnancy can be seriously harmful to the developing fetus, as nicotine can cross the placenta to fetal circulation. It can deprive the fetus of oxygen and cause growth retardation. Nicotine exposure during pregnancy has also been associated with learning and behavioral problems in children. Teenagers are more likely to be vulnerable to nicotine addiction. This is because acetaldehyde, another chemical in tobacco, reinforces the effects of nicotine. And this appears to be more profound in adolescents. People with mental troubles like depression, PTSD, or schizophrenia are more likely to be smokers than other people. Genetic makeup also seems to play a role in susceptibility to addiction. So, nicotine dependence can also be inherited. Genes involved in how the brain responds to nicotine and nicotine clearance are likely to contribute to the inheritance. For instance, people who metabolize nicotine slowly tend to smoke fewer cigarettes and can also quit smoking with lesser effort. On the other hand, they are also at risk for nicotine buildup in the body. People who can clear out nicotine rapidly tend to smoke more cigarettes and may have difficulty quitting the habit. Other genes involved in nicotine dependence play a role in dopamine production on exposure to nicotine, nicotine absorption, and serotonin pathways. Analyzing these genes can give you insights into your risk for nicotine dependence. You can do this through a simple genetic test. Most genetic tests provide your DNA information in the form of a text file called the raw DNA data. This data may seem like Greek and Latin to you. We, at Xcode Life, can help you interpret this data. All you have to do is upload your raw data and order a gene nutrition report. Xcode Life then analyzes your raw data in detail to provide you with comprehensive nutrition analysis, including information on nicotine dependence genes.